that was probably a lot of people's maybe first time they'd heard electronic music, you know, on the score to that film. It made me forever associate classical music with people getting their heads kicked in, which is kind of a bit strange.
But in 1978, the Human League weren't the only group experimenting with electronics in Sheffield.
This is the old Salter Line Art College, which used to be part of Sheffield Polytechnic in the 1970s. I believe the Human League also played this very place for their first ever live show in Sheffield. Cabaret Voltaire did perform in this very room.
Yeah, I mean, we just thought there was nothing for us, you know. I mean, it was all kind of bloated super groups and progressive bands who weren't even from the same kind of social backgrounds, you know. They were probably public school educators, whereas I think, you know, most of the scene in Sheffield was pretty solid, kind of working class. You'd find little bits of interesting music within perhaps some of the prog rock stuff where there'd be a weird little synth break. But then, you know, once you kind of start to discover all the German bands, you realise that there were entire albums that were made of electronics.
Whilst the Human League dreamt of pop, Cabaret Voltaire were anything but, using electronics to explore Sheffield, a city torn between the past and the future.
I remember watching loads of science fiction things in the 60s, like Doctor Who and things like Quatermass. And all these kind of strange things seem to happen in kind of old gasworks or industrial environment. There was another worldliness about it. You might see an alien or a giant blob creeping across the floor, glowing bright green from radioactivity.
Very arty group. Obviously, the name echoes Dada. They were really into William Burroughs and his ideas of like control and surveillance. They actually used quite a lot of guitar, but it was so heavily processed it didn't sound like rock and roll guitar. It sounded more like a synthesizer. They also put synthesizing type effects on the voice, which was probably one of the most disturbing things they did. You know, they have a guy singing, but it sounds more like a Dalek than, you know, a human being.
At night time, you'd hear distant booming noises, which, you know, would probably be something like a drop forge or steam hammer or something. You certainly knew that you were on the edge of, you know, heavy industry.
Everything in their music was kind of alienated, and, you know, the music that comes from people who are kind of divorced from any kind of natural life, any natural rhythms, the music for a kind of hostile environment.
Not everyone wanted in on booming Britain. Cabaret Voltaire were neither into ponytails nor popularity. Their vision of Britain was concerned with the inner city riots that erupted across the country in summer 81.
People say that the special Ghost Town was the soundtrack to the unrest of that year. But a lot of people, you know, alternatively think that Red Mecca was the sound of that. And, you know, I think I've said in the past somehow that insurrection on the streets kind of found its way into the music. And you kind of took some heart in the fact that some people were kicking back against the system, albeit in a quite a crude manner, and were prepared to take on the police. You know, we weren't paranoid. This stuff was slowly happening, you know, the rise of surveillance culture, the rise of the, you know, right wing in America, the fundamentalist Christians.
Jehovah, in the name of Jesus.
And then you got, like, the revolution in Iran, with the Shah being deposed and the general feeling that things are moving to the right.
Meanwhile, something strangely synthetic was happening in the sleazy underbelly of London's Soho.